Hey, High Levelers, Rayo Daniel here. On this video, I'm not going to be going over any new features. What I wanted to do is go over the LC phone system and then some issues and troubles that I personally have been having that has cost me hours of my time trying to figure this out because it's not very well documented. So if you're having problems with the LC phone system, if you're not quite sure why it responds one way when you configure it like this and another way when you uncheck this box, I'm going to try to help you understand the documentation that currently exists with Highlevel and some of the other troubleshooting tips that I've found by talking to the Highlevel, like when I mean Highlevel technicians that have had to help me out on this, actually clarify a few things. So I hope you find this video useful and very time savings when it comes to the LC phone system, especially when you're configuring some of the newer settings. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. I always appreciate your support. So let's go ahead and kind of get into it. First of all, what I want to do is go over the documentation Highlevel currently has and kind of walk you through that. And then I'm going to punch a few holes into stuff that doesn't really work right inside of Highlevel phone system that really is not very well documented. And if you get on the troubleshooting call with them, this isn't something that first tier support is going to be able to help you out with. You're going to have to, like me, go to the top tier support. And it took me weeks to finally get somebody that can actually understand this and help me figure out some of these problems. So I'm hoping this really saves you some time. So right now there's a document in Highlevel called Inbound Call Routing. Now this is a great document that does explain a few things. It's a little bit outdated, but I wanna show you this right here. So first of all, before I go over this document, I do wanna let you know that the LC phone system is not like any other voice over IP phone system that you've ever had. And let me explain what that means. I've dealt with several different voice over IP phone systems, business phone system settings. Now typically what I would expect from a voice over IP phone system is you register with just somebody outside of LC phone, just a regular voice over IP system here. You log in, you get a local phone number, an 800 phone number, whatever. You just get a phone number. Whenever somebody dials that phone number, typically if you're logged into the web application for that particular phone system, you may get a web interface to answer and answer the phone calls. This is typically how VAs answer it when you have VAs monitoring stuff. They just log into the web browser and it rings on the web browser. And then they're able to see an inbound phone call. They can take the phone call, answer it, they can make a phone call, and that's how it works with all the inbound phone calls. Now, most of the voice over IP providers do also issue a mobile app. So that you can download a mobile app, Android, iPhone, it doesn't really matter. And if you're logged into that app, then when somebody dials your phone number on that voice over IP system, it will ring both. It can ring the web version of it, or it can ring the mobile app. Some providers have settings that allow you to choose between either one of them. But this is typically how it works. You call and then you basically, if you're logged in the mobile app, you see the mobile app ringing, you answer it, and then you know it's coming from your voice over IP business phone. Now, that's initially how I expected Highlevel to work here. Excuse me. It does not. Highlevel does not work that way. So do not ever expect the LC phone system to perform that way, because that's just not how they designed it and that's how it's built. So now that kind of throws another wrench into it. Okay, great. Now how do I configure it? So this right here, this document that we're going to go over, is how their call routing happens. And I'm going to go over this a few steps here, and then we're going to, again, look over some other settings, especially with the new IVR system that has been set up inside of Highlevel. Very cool feature. But I want to show you how that works with this whole phone call routing stuff as well. So here, if we take a look, and for some reason, this 1 and 2 is basically the same in the documentation. I don't get it, but it's just, if the number inside of Highlevel is assigned to a user, that's pretty straightforward here. Now, you can assign phone numbers directly to a user, or you cannot. There has to be one number that's left as default, and that's typically just the first number, and that default number is going to be what's called whenever you send a text message out, a voicemail drop, something like that is always going to be able to use the default phone number. Now, you can't really change that right now. They haven't been able to give you the option to do that yet. So the default number is used for all outbound workflow calls and so forth, unless it's specifically assigned to a user. So if it's specifically assigned to a user inside of the workflow, you can do that by using the assignment, assigned to user action on that one. Well, if it's assigned to a user and that user has a phone number inside of Highlevel, then it will utilize that phone number moving forward. So that's one way that you can kind of get around it. But if you don't use the assigned by user, then you won't, it'll just use the default number. But biggest thing is that if a phone number is assigned to a user, okay, then that user will get the phone call, and that phone call will go into their particular voicemail. Now, there is an area inside of the user configuration. If we just take a look here and go to the team setup here, and we'll just pick somebody here. We'll just pick me here. So if you come down to the call and voice settings, this right here is where you can select a particular phone number here in this dropdown, and you've got voicemail settings. So here in this little box, you can upload, if we blow this up, you can upload a voice file, and that would be your voicemail for that particular phone number for that user. So that's what that means when it says, is the phone number assigned to a user? That one is pretty straightforward and easy. What I'm talking about, some of the issues I've had, is the default phone number, like the main marketing phone number that isn't assigned to anybody. It's just sort of the company phone number, if you will. If it is assigned to a user, then things are much, much easier and simpler. So number two is the same thing. If a contact or lead is calling a Twilio number assigned to a user, that's the same thing that we just talked about. Now, here's where it kind of gets interesting. Does a Twilio number have a forwarding number set? So if a forwarding number is set inside of the phone number, we'll take a look at that, then it will send it over to the forwarding phone number. So that is the priority. That is what has priority over the main phone line. Now it says, if there isn't any forward, now, if there's no forwarding number listed, then what it does is it falls back to the company phone number field. So, hey, real quick, guys, if you're looking to start your own software company, then click on my free course in the link below. I'm going to teach you 8 ways that you can start your own software company very easily with no money out of pocket, no experience, and absolutely no tech skills. Check it out. Click the link below, and let's get back to the video. Before I kind of get into this, let me hop over to the phone areas and just kind of show you this. So if you come in and edit the configuration, this forwarding phone calls too. This field is where you would have your forwarding phone number into. If you want to forward it to your business line, forward it to a phone number, tech out in the field, whatever it is, then it will always forward to that particular number. So now with that, if that is not set, if you don't have any forwarding number in there, then what it will do is it will come into the business profile area and it will look here into the business phone. Now, if there is something listed in the business phone, which is in the document right here, if there's a number in the company phone field in the business tab, then it will always route to that particular business phone, whatever that is. Now, this is regardless of even, well, I'm kind of jumping ahead of myself here, but let's just say if there's a phone number in that field, then it will forward it to that company phone number. However, let me kind of go over some settings that regarding some new releases that Highlevel recently released. Now, I'm going to scroll back out of this and, come back over here to the phone number field. Now, one of the nice features that Highlevel has just recently released here is the ring group feature. So if we look down here, there's this new feature called ring incoming call to users. This is a great new feature. I have a video on my YouTube channel. You can go watch it if you like. But this is just a real quick way of allowing multiple people to be called at one time. Now here at the very top, this forwarding number was limited. You only had one phone that could be forwarded to, and that was the only phone number that it went to. Well, that was kind of limiting. So here, instead of doing that, what you can do is you can ring that phone number, and you can also ring 2, 3, up to, as you can see, up to 8 different people can be listed here, and it will ring all of their phones at once. So all of that stuff will ring all at once, and whoever answers first is the one that wins. Now, here's the problem that I kept running into. Finally, we're at the point where we can start talking about some of the issues here. The ring incoming call users feature does not work if there is a company phone number field assigned. So that doesn't make any sense to me, and I'm going to say it again. If you have a phone number field here in the business phone, it doesn't matter who you have configured under the ring group. The LC phone system will route to this business phone if there's nothing in the forwarding phone field, just like in the documentation. So this is how it works. If there's a forwarding number, it goes to it. If there's no forwarding number, it goes to the business phone. So nowhere in this routing process does it actually look at the ring group to see if there's a ring group enabled. They may change this in the future, but right now, this is what one of the struggles I had was trying to implement this new feature and then it not working. It doing some crazy stuff when you actually start testing the phone system. So again, not having a business phone in there, if you take that business phone number out, then the ring group feature will actually work correctly. And when the ring group works correctly in this same area, here underneath the business profile area, this is where you can configure your company. So that means the default number. If you have a default phone number assigned to your company, not a number assigned to a user, that's different. We already talked about those user settings, but if there's no number assigned to a user and there's a company voicemail set here, this is what will play. So this is the company voicemail that gets played and then they can leave a message and that message then shows up under the conversations area inside of the CRM. Now, here's the problem. The problem is with these forwarding phone numbers on the business line and then that forwarding number, if it's set, that's limiting, it'll only go there, and then here if this business phone number is set. The problem with this is that this business phone could be very vital to you because this business phone is actually the location phone number. If you ever looked at some of your contact fields where you can pull in the account name, your account email, things like that, the account information is what's configured here on this screen. And the problem is that because of the way the phone system may be set up, the business phone may have to be blank in order for it to work correctly. And if it is blank, then nowhere in your email or your text message where you ever have the account.location configured or account.phone, then that will never work. You see, and that's the problem here is you have to choose one or the other and make accommodations for each one of them. But if you do want the ring group feature to work, you do have to have no forwarding number enabled. This forwarding number has to be gone, and you have to delete the business phone system first. When you do that, then the ring groups will actually ring correctly. What I've found is that even with the business phone in there, it'll ring once to the group, like not even enough for you to answer the phone call, and then it will go right into, go whatever to the business phone. So if the business phone is routed or it goes into another voicemail system, then it'll go to that voicemail system and leave the voicemail on that system and not inside of Highlevel, which doesn't do you any good because now you're checking two systems for messages. Highlevel, the phone system, and then the business phone, wherever that is. It could be a cell phone, it could be whatever, but now you have a voicemail on that system that you have to go find. Very frustrating. So that right there is some of the issues that I ran across. Now, to kind of bring up the newest feature of Highlevel is the new IVR feature. So inside of automations here, we're going to take a quick look at just a setup that I had set up here. So if you're dealing with the IVR setup here, and this isn't a tutorial over the IVR system, but it is a very cool feature that now you're allowed to create a workflow that actually has more of like a phone tree or a phone assistant, whatever you call, different voiceover IP providers call it different things. But here's where it's, press one for this, press two for this. So you can actually kind of have a phone tree built inside of Highlevel now and then route it using these cool items in the workflow. Now, if you do have this new feature here, this is one of the things I will say, and I'm not gonna go over, this is just one way. If you take a look here, you've got this call trigger. Basically what it is, you've got a trigger that you can set up for the IVR for each phone number. So you can have an IVR for every phone number that you have because the trigger is set at a filter level to a specific phone number. So that's pretty cool. I mean, so that you could even have that on a user level. There's no reason you couldn't have this same IVR on every team member's account and have a workflow that handles that, which is pretty cool because, I mean, right now, if you think about it, well, I'm kind of getting off on the IVR, but take a look at the other video on the channel that has for IVR setup. It goes in a lot more depth, but you can do some really cool things with this. But from this, what I found out here on my investigations is if you do have the IVR enabled, okay, so if you have the IVR turned on, then you can have the business phone number inside of the business settings and have that not interfere. So somehow when you're looking at this call routing document, they have changed this call routing document flow, but they haven't documented it because I've been on the phone with at least five different times with Highlevel support trying to get some of the answers to why this particular thing doesn't work and that feature doesn't work. Or every time I check a box or uncheck something, it has different results, like majorly different results. And it can be kind of frustrating if you're setting this up for your client and you're just trying to get a basic phone system set up to where it works. People call in if the phone number may be routed over to the owner on their cell phone. If the owner can't answer it, then it goes back into Highlevel, and then Highlevel can then pick up that contact phone number, create a contact record, and store the voicemail. And when they store the voicemail, then lo and behold, on the LeadConnector app, when the owner is logged in, you will get a notification that somebody called you and potentially left you a message, and the owner can pull up the LeadConnector app, go to conversations, pull up that, listen to the phone call, and actually return the phone call directly from the mobile app. Super cool. So just doing some basic setup like that can be very frustrating if you don't know some of the ins and outs of how the phone system works. So that's really why I wanted to create this video to let you know. So back to this. Here in the very bottom, and between steps 3 and 4 that you see here, there is another step that Highlevel has implemented in the IVR system. So if you do have an IVR and it is published, you publish the workflow, it does go through and interfere even with the call forwarding number. So call forwarding number, even if you have a company phone number field in there, the IVR sort of takes priority and rings that first. So if you are using an IVR, you're probably not gonna have a lot of these issues. The issues that I really had that came into this had to deal with implementing ring groups inside of Highlevel, and it just not performing right. Like it wouldn't ring, it would time out, or it would sit back and leave a voicemail on the person. And this is one thing that I will let you know too. If you're dealing with ring groups here, this whisper message, be careful with that. One of the things I found out, a lot of people like the whisper message because basically what this is you pick it up and it calls and it just says call from, and then it just tells you, call from your office. And it lets you know ahead of time that you're getting a call from the office, so you can either decline it or, you can hang up or you can wait and answer it. Perfect. But the problem is that if you're getting a whisper message here and you've got the ring group enabled, then what's going to happen is that, and I didn't test this on multiple phones, but I did test this like on my phone. What's end up going to happening is each person that's in the ring group, if they don't answer, if nobody answers, everybody in the ring group gets a voicemail from the phone number in the default phone number, just saying the whisper message. So, you know, even though you didn't answer the phone, you'll still get a voicemail message dealing with this whisper message here if it's turned on. I thought that was kind of annoying myself how that worked. So I ended up having to turn the whisper feature off in order to not have that happen and then actually have it pass completely through. Now, one of the things I did find useful here is if you're dealing with a business phone number, you can click here and just say pass caller ID number, call number as caller ID. So basically what that does is simply let you know that every time you call, if you have whatever your default phone number and Highlevel configured on your phone, you will see that phone number come across the message when somebody calls. That way you know by looking at the number that it's coming in from the office, but you won't know the caller ID of the person calling you until you answer it and pick it up. There's no way of really doing that from the phone perspective. But at least it prepares you for, you know where the call is coming from. If you don't have this box checked, then the caller ID of the inbound caller just gets passed directly to your phone. And when you pick up the phone, you don't really know if this number is going to be from a friend, from a marketing call, or if it's going to be a business call. And if you're a salesperson, the thing that's very frustrating is that you never want to pass up on a sales call, but you may want to pass up on a spam likely call or something like that. Well, you could still get that same call from somebody calling in from the office. They could be using a spam likely call, a customer number coming in. That happens. So you just never want to miss an opportunity for a sales call. Well, one way to know that for sure is to just check this box and pass the call number as a caller ID. So that way, again, you get the phone number from the office calling you, and you know for a fact that this number is coming from the office. And you can always go back into the mobile app or the CRM to see the inbound caller, because you'll see that in the conversations area, or worst case is just go look at the contacts, and that'll be a newly created contact, and it'll show them actually making a phone call into the office if you ever want to track that down. But anyway, those are just a few things that I found that can really save you just a ton of time when you're trying to get this phone system set up inside of Highlevel to get it set up correctly and just get it up and going. So if you have any questions over this, please leave me a comment below. I have gone through extensively with this, and it's just been, you know, kind of a learning experience and a little bit frustrating, to be honest, at the same time. But this is the way that the LC phone system works. These are the routing rules that they have, and you just have to be able to follow them. And as long as you know how to set it up, then you can set up the same situation over and over again. Now, what I recommend is that if you're doing the same thing for every particular client, which most of the time you should be, that should be a part of your standard operating procedure. You come in, and one of the first things you're going to do for call tracking is set up an inbound call number inside of Highlevel. You might set up multiple numbers, but you're going to at least set up one so that you could set up the Google My Business. All the other business listings are going to be set to this number so that you could track all new customers, and you could do all the missed call text back feature, all that other cool stuff. You need to make sure that how you handle call routing is defined very well based upon how the phone system works, because you don't want to spend time troubleshooting this for every client that you set up a phone system for. So that's another thing that you need to figure out. Also, one of the other things that you need to be able to pay attention to, again, is the A2P compliant registration. Now, I will pass this along. I'm not an attorney. Please, you know, address your attorney for this, but A2P, from my understanding, really goes back to a business to customer compliance. Now, if you're doing business to business type of communications, A2P really doesn't fit into that particular model very well. It's not that I've seen. It's really more for consumers. So you just can't buy a list of 5,000 people and then text all 5,000 people and spam them if they haven't signed up for your list. That's kind of what the A2P protection is for there. That's why you have to register your campaigns. You have to explain what you're doing when it comes to the consumer base. But this really doesn't apply to business to business. So you can still text a business. You can still text them without having to have this particular problem. But just want to pass that along. That's another thing that I found out. And again, guys, if you have any questions, please leave me a comment. If you found this video useful, click the like button. You know those stats. YouTube loves them. It's going to help me out a lot, and I always appreciate your help because I'm here for you. I'm trying to help as best I can. So just let me know if there's anything else. And again, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button. As always, I appreciate your support, and have a great day. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you're looking to learn more about the GoHighlevel system, platform, and maybe you even want to start your own software as a service company, click on the description below. I offer a free course, and this course goes over all the things you would need to know regarding Highlevel. I even teach you 8 ways that you can make money with a Highlevel system with no experience, no tech skills, and no money out of pocket. Check out my link in the description below, and have a great day.